There was a time when resources seemed endless. But in 2030, the great energy crisis began. With hardly any resources left on our world, global powers created the World Space Agency to look beyond the Earth for answers. The answer was found in helium-3, a powerful isotope discovered in abundance on the moon. With it, humanity could satisfy its energy demand for decades to come. And so, in 2032, mankind colonized the moon. Spearheaded by the Lunar Council, the WSA constructed several permanent settlements to harvest and process helium-3. The resulting energy was transferred to Earth through a revolutionary energy network, the Microwave Power Transmission, or MPT. For a time, all seemed well. Then, one fateful night in 2054, the lights went out. No energy. The MPT had gone offline, and communication with the lunar colonists was lost. Without earthly resources to launch a full-scale rescue mission to the moon, the World Space Agency was shut down permanently in 2055. But a small group of former WSA colonists refused to accept humanity's bleak future. Determined to discover the colony's fate and to restore the MPT, they've been preparing their mission in an abandoned desert launch facility. Now, in 2059, they are ready to launch an astronaut to the moon. What awaits is unknown and unforeseeable, but the mission is clear. Deliver us the moon.
Of the missing lunar colonists gather all around the world tonight in remembrance of the 2054 MPT blackout that resulted in a global power outage and the loss of contact with the lunar colony. The blackout caused global turmoil, which ultimately led to the closure of the World Space Agency 1 year later. In other news, the recent formation of the largest dust storm on record has prompted climatologists to readjust their forecast of the equatorial desert's growth rate. As a result of the new storm, the desert could soon cover 30% of the globe's landmass. Several governments have pledged support for refugees, despite reports of resource shortages. The dust storm is expected to hit residential zones between the northern 49th and 50th latitude lines by late afternoon, and pass over the World Space Agency's former MPT ground station in the Arirau Desert. Authorities have imposed a mandatory evacuation of the impacted areas. For countries north of the equatorial desert, temperatures are expected to be a mild 46 degrees Celsius. This was Nicole Cage for World News 1, September 16, 2059, wishing you a safe and happy day.
Are you there? Ground control to Fortuna 1, this is Claire. Please confirm radio contact. Radio contact confirmed. Make your way to the launch platform and prime the rocket for liftoff. We have to launch before the dust storm hits. There she is, the Taurus 5. It took us 4 years to get her ready for launch. But you need to hurry. The dust storm will hit this area in a few hours. If we don't succeed now, the Fortuna mission will be over for good. the facility. The control center is located on the top floor. There you can prime the rocket for launch. It's been 5 years since we last received a microwave power transmission from the lunar colony. At first, no one believed it would be possible to transmit energy from the moon back to Earth. But the WSA proved the skeptics wrong. Just like you will, when you get the MPT back online. Once functioned as part of the WSA, but it's been our home for many years now. I still can't believe we'll be leaving here for good soon. The desertification of this whole region won't take long after the storm passes through.
For the MPT blackout. One, the transmitter at Pearson Space Station. Claire, there you are. Come on, we're celebrating in the other room. Everyone is looking for you.
I need to go over this one last time, Maria.
We've been over it before, multiple times. We're good. Come, it's time to join the party.
It won't take long. I'll be right there.
A true Johansson. Once he set his mind to something, I could never convince him either. You're just as stubborn as your father.
Probably the only thing we have in common. I just don't understand why he didn't restore the MPT connection. He invented the damn thing. And now it's just us. No one else is even trying. If we fail...
Remember what I told you. If it can be done, then we're going to do it. That's all we have to focus on. Go over your notes. Join us when you're ready.
Good. You're in the control center. Get the rocket ready to launch as fast as possible. Calculating new storm ETA. Claire, we have a problem. The storm is approaching faster than expected. Way faster. Time's running out. Keep going, Fortuna. We've been working too long to give up now.
Thank you.
valves are closed, head back inside the control center to prime the rocket for launch. Navigation systems online. We're nearly there. It's just like your training. You can do this. Initiate launch procedure. Ground launch sequencer started. Orbital access arm retracting. Perfect. Just like with practice. Holding, but barely. Try to go easy on the equipment. Vent arm safely in place. Sound suppression system engaged. Hydrogen burn-off system activated. Rocket boosters ready for ignition. Standing by for countdown. Rocket boosters, ignition start. Engines ready in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We have liftoff!
To the moon just 100 years ago. They knew an Earth full of life. All we know today is dust. If you can bring the MPT network back online, it could restore the hope humanity lost after the lunar colony fell. We could recover, rebuild, and most of all, start thinking about a future. You'll need to find the MPT transmitter at the Pearson Space Station. From there, the power signal was relayed to Earth. This was the final link in the MPT network before the blackout. If there are answers to find, they're at Pearson.
Claire, we need to head down to the shelter. These winds are getting bad.
Understood. Fortuna 1, this storm is going to jam radio contact. You'll be on your own for a while. To reach the station, you must... Once you're in the purple... It's the second stage of the law. Please, deliver us the moon.
Backup power activated. Life support systems online. Oxygen levels rising.
Copy, Control. We're all set. Ready for descent.
The MPT network is still down, so expect the lights to go out as you descend towards Copernicus.
Thanks for the heads up, Pearson.
Remember, Sarah, our oxygen here in the station is limited. After arriving, you'll have 40 minutes to find out what caused the blackout and bring our MPT network back online. If you're not back by then, we'll have to evacuate without you.
We hear you, Control. Rolf, you ready?
I am. And don't worry, Control. It's probably just a glitch. We'll be back before you know it.
Let's find out how they've been holding up down there. Alex, commence descent protocol.
All systems go. Descent in 3, 2, 1. Descent engaged.
Buddy, almost there. We'll touch up your paint job later, don't worry.
Are you ready to go? We've almost got the elevator running again.
Yeah, just patching up Alex before we head down.
Are you bringing that thing along?
Of course. We'll need all the help we can get. Besides, you wouldn't have made it to that airlock if it hadn't been for him. This MPT blackout can't be just a glitch, Rolf. Everything is still dark down there. Last time there was an outage. Did you hear the message from Earth?
No. What did they say?
They can't even send ships up here anymore without the MPT. It's crazy, right? We're the only ones able to investigate the blackout.
Sarah, we need to get you guys down to the surface ASAP. We don't have much time.
Okay, let's go.
Inner One, we're still not reading anything from the MPT. Is everything under control up there?
That. Do you think we'll finish construction anytime soon?
Was the council claiming more supplies each week? I doubt it. I'm surprised we got this past MacArthur in the first place.
Yeah. Hey, listen, I'm getting strange readings here from the lunar surface. Are you seeing anything?
Just wrapping up. What the hell? All the lights are shutting down.
Are you all right, Rolf? What just happened?
I can't see a thing. Everything is dark out here.
We lost power from the MPT. The whole station is down. Can you find your way back to the airlock?
Negative. I don't have a visual.
Right. I'm sending Alex to block the airlock doors. Do you see him?
I see his flashlight. Heading back to the airlock. What's going on? Everything on the surface is dark.
Rolf, not now. What's your ETA?
10 seconds.
Make it faster. Once the airlock seals, you'll be locked out. Alex is blocking the door for you, but he can't hold it much longer.
Life support energy supply at 40%. Life support, energy supply at 20%. Energy supply critical. Power fully redirected from life support to rotation engine. Access control center to activate engine. Life support failing. Life support shutting down. Oxygen reserves low.
Hello? Hello? It seems empty. Where is everyone?
I have no idea. I've never seen the base like this. Is Alex getting any heat signatures?
No, nothing. This can't be right. I'll go downstairs, see what I can find.
Sarah, we'll figure this one out. And thank you, both of you, for saving me when the blackout hit. I know I,
Expedition team, you must be at the surface by now. Remember, you only have 40 minutes down there.
Copy that, Pearson. Don't mention it, Rolf. Can you check out the control center and see what's wrong with the MPT?
Will do.
Keep your comms on. I'll update you when I find something.
William, what the hell was that speech about?
Our next chapter, Rosa. It's time. The ships will be ready soon.
You can't be serious. I don't know how you plan to fix this mess, but you'd better do it now.
That won't be necessary. Come with me.
You are serious. Will, have you lost your mind? We can't leave the colony behind like this, not during this blackout. Not with the MPT signal still offline. People on Earth depend on us.
Don't concern yourself with them. Those days are over. We have to start the long journey ahead. That was the agreement.
The ships were supposed to be our last resort. We didn't give up the first time, and we are not giving up now. When the network is back online, we can provide Earth with power again. We are close, William.
No, we're not. We're not close at all. If you still think we can power the entirety of Earth with the MPT, you're more delusional than I thought. We have one last hope, and it's outward. Now get ready, because we're going.
I'm not leaving, Will. Not like this.
I'm not asking. Get her on the ship.
What? Is this really...
Initiating AZ maintenance protocol. Running AZ hardware diagnostic. AZ connection to Moon Hub facility network. Failed. AZ network access port status. Defective. Component replacement is advised. AZ network access port replacement successful. AZ connection to Moonhub facility network established. Proceeding with AZ hardware diagnostic. AZ thruster status. Defective. Full thruster replacement is advised. AZ thruster replacement successful. Initiate reboot to complete maintenance protocol. Thank you. Local lockdown canceled.
This is Isaac.
Hi.
I'm not sure if this message will ever reach you. I don't think it will. But I'm trying anyway. We haven't spoken since the argument about Kathy. I want you to know that she's safe and well. This message will be the last you'll ever get from me, or from anyone else up here. It's probably something you'll never understand. Hell, I barely do. If someone ever finds out what happened here, know that I did it for her. For your sister. To give her a chance. But you'll do great. You'll do great things. Take care. I love you. I wish I said that more often. Back when you still called me Dad. Goodbye, Claire.
Still no trace. This just doesn't feel right. Alex, scan for data history. There's a recording. Rolf, come in. I think I've got something. I found a recording from the 23rd.
Home to the state-of-the-art fusion reactor, the Tombow facility is the heart of humanity's mining operations. Spanning a distance of over 400 kilometers to connect to the moon's surface, the Pearson Space Elevator is by far the tallest structure in human history. Safe, secure, and comfortable, the station connects moon and man. The monumental and ambitious construction was completed in 2041, when the station was crowned with the MPT transmitter. With it, the MPT network was finally complete. Pearson Space Station. Our stairway to the stars. Copernicus Moonhub, where the Lunar Council and the pioneering astronauts constructed the first sustainable outpost on the moon. Seasoned explorers and aspiring colonists alike gather on this historical site. It is amongst them that you will find your place in protecting a prosperous future for all. It is here that greatness dawns. The microwave power transmission is a technological marvel that provides both Earth and the lunar colony with power. Energy from the Tombow reactor is relayed across the frontier through Copernicus Moonhub and Pearson Station. As the transmission is received by the vast array 42 MPT ground stations along Earth's equator. It is distributed with equality and fairness to bring light to our families back home. We provide the new flame for everyone.
That's what? 2 days ago.
Copy, Control. We're all set. Ready for descent.
The MPT network is still down, so expect the lights to go out as you descend towards Copernicus.
Thanks for the heads up, Pearson. Still no trace. This just doesn't feel right. Alex, scan for data history. There's a recording. Rolf, come in. I think I've got something. I found a recording from the 23rd.
That's what, 2 days ago? Are you sure?
Yeah. Can you see it from up there?
I think so. Go ahead.
Alex, project hologram from September 23rd, 2054. This isn't just the moon-up crew. There's too many of them. These are Tombow evacuees.
How do you know?
These names weren't here before. There's still dust on the stone.
On the monument, you mean?
Yeah. Victims of the Tombow evacuation. The date is the day of the blackout. Something big must have happened over at Tombow.
Pearson, coming in for expedition team. Sarah, Rolf, anything on the state of the MPT?
The entire network is down. I've had no luck with bringing it back online so far.
Make it quick. If things don't work out with the network, head back up here, whether the MPT is online or not. You have 20 minutes left to make it in time for evac.
Copy that, Control. Rolf, I'll check out the living quarters and then head back to the elevator.
Maintenance offline. Vehicle bay offline.
Hold up. Do you see the people down there? They will be the start of a new chapter. Together, we will be humanity's future.
At what cost, William?
We're saving the species so we can start again. If this is what it takes for humanity to survive, I'll gladly take responsibility. There you are, Johansson. Without your help, this wouldn't have been possible.
Isaac? This was not the agreement, you know that. We need to get the MPT back online.
Be realistic, Rosa. Even if we ever manage to provide Earth with all the power it needs, what do we truly gain? More time to see oceans and deserts taking our homes. William, I've done my part. Let's just go. I'm done with this mess.
You heard the man? Let's go. Outward begins.
William, what the hell was that speech about?
Our next chapter, Rosa. It's time. The ships will be ready soon.
You can't be serious. I don't know how you plan to fix this mess, but you'd better do it now.
That won't be necessary. Come with me.
You are serious. Will, have you lost your mind? We can't leave the colony behind like this, not during this blackout. Not with the MPT signal still offline. People on Earth depend on us.
Don't concern yourself with them. Those days are over. We have to start the long journey ahead. That was the agreement.
The ships were supposed to be our last resort. We didn't give up the first time, and we are not giving up now. When the network is back online, we can provide Earth with power again. We are close, William.
No, we're not. We're not close at all. If you still think we can power the entirety of Earth with the MPT, you're more delusional than I thought. We have one last hope, and it's outward. Now get ready, because we're going.
I'm not leaving, Will. Not like this.
I'm not asking. Get her on the ship.
What? Is this really...
Vehicle bay sealed.
Come in, Rolf. I'm at the quarters. Do you read me?
Copy that, Sarah. I hear you. Anything interesting?
Everything's deserted, so nothing new here.
Sarah, Rolf, this is Pearson Control. Our time's running out. Take the elevator back up here to make it in time for evacuation. You've got 2 minutes. Negative, Control. MPT network is still offline. Leave it. We have to go. Head to the elevator now. I'm not putting anyone at risk. Understood. Wrapping up now. Sarah, you heard Control. Are you almost here? Sarah, come in. Everything okay? Come in.
Rolf, get over here quickly. An AZ unit just activated, but something's not right. The doors are locked behind me.
What do you mean? We've got to go.
I'm serious, Rolf. Get over here. I can't get out.
30 seconds or you're too late for evac. Head to the elevator.
Negative
now.
Control. Engineer Baker requires immediate assistance. We need more time.
Evacuation procedure cannot be delayed.
Negative.
I'm calling up the elevator now.
Negative, Control. Control.
No, guys! There's still time! I just need some help. Rolf, are you still there? No!
Vehicle bay online.
protocol, we detected activity in the MPT network. We haven't seen that in years. It seems to have been a local power transmission, isolated from the power source at the Tombo facility. Something must be wrong at the reactor there. Tombo isn't close, though. Traveling by foot would be suicide. Perhaps you can find another means of transportation inside Moon Hub. I hope you come.
Today we find ourselves at a crossroads. The catastrophic events that have unfolded at the Tombo facility have opened our eyes to a truth that cannot be denied. We have lost friends, colleagues. Our fellow colonists gave their life for a hopeless cause, for a dying planet that we could never sustain. We used to call it home. Our pale blue dot. But the Earth we know today is a withered husk, a shadow of its former self. The MPT chained us to a barren rock. But no more. All of you gathered here are survivors. You're here because you're mankind's strongest, the smartest, the brightest. Together, we will dare to leap and risk greatness, start a new age of discovery, like our ancestors that fateful moment they first set out to explore new worlds. We can turn back and confine ourselves to a dying planet, or we can look outward. Now is the time to act. Make your decision. And make it now. A new beginning dawns for humanity, and it dawns today.
was that speech all about? MacArthur can't decide this on his own now, can he?
Look, we don't call the shots here, okay? Now help me out with this stuff.
Put that down, Frank. Don't you know what helium is for? Don't you think it's strange it's here instead of next to the reactor it's supposed to power?
Of course I do, it's just a...
Just what? Should we accept everything they say? Do you even realize what the consequences are if we leave while the MPT is offline?
What choice do we have? What do we really have to go back to? Floods, dust storms, blazing heat? I'm done. The Council's giving us a second chance, and I'm not wasting it. Now, I'm done talking. Just give me a hand.
This is Sarah Baker, lead engineer at Pearson Space Station. I was sent to investigate the blackout together with station mechanic Rolf Robertson. I was attacked by an AZ unit and lost consciousness. The reasons for this attack remain unclear. It seems my expedition partner has left, and I am unable to contact Pearson Space Station or any of the other facilities. I'm going to cross the frontier now, passing Copernicus Outpost 1. To get to Tombow and try to figure out what caused the MPT failure. Whoever finds this, please try to contact me. Alex, end recording.
Copernicus 1 colonists, this is an evacuation. The reactor at Tombow has suffered a critical malfunction. We're here to evacuate you to Copernicus Moon Hub.
Whoa, calm down. Who sent you?
We're here on official orders of the Lunar Council.
The Lunar Council? Frank, do you see anything strange happening across the MPT network?
I've got nothing out of the ordinary. Tombow seems fine to me.
Perhaps you could explain a bit more first.
This is for your own safety. The situation will be explained by the Council when all colonists arrive at Moon Hub.
So, MacArthur calls the shots now, huh?
We don't have time for this. Just take them.
What? Get your hands off me!
Evacuation crew to MacArthur, we're progressing to Stage 2. Outpost crew and the package are on their way to Moon Hub. We didn't receive any word from the others at Reinhold, though.
Good work, Evac. Wait for them to pass Outpost 1. Contact me again when the second evacuation crew arrives. Over and out.
This is Pearson Station Engineer Sarah Baker again. I traveled to this outpost from Moonhub, where I was sent to investigate the blackout together with my expedition partner. Moonhub was completely deserted when we arrived, and we were unable to bring the MPT back online. We got separated and lost contact. I'm traveling towards Tombo alone to continue my investigation. The only lead I have is that something has happened at the reactor facility. The entrance to the monorail station here is blocked, so I'll have to find another way to cross the landscape. It's worth a shot.
Evacuation crew to MacArthur. Helium package and Copernicus Outpost 1 personnel have arrived in Moonhub, sir. Evac crew 2 is still nowhere in sight, though. We've been trying to reach them, but we're getting no response at all. How should we proceed?
Seal the door and make your way to Moonhub. Fuel needs to be in place before we arrive with the Tomba evacuees.
Sir, the other crew won't make it in time if I do that. They'll miss the launch.
They know what they signed up for. Seal the door, now.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
Tombo track access denied. Communication with closest base operator offline. Consult operator on arrival in Reinhold Crater Base. Warning, Tombo track locked. Switch tracks to avert fatal collision. Warning, obstruction detected. Switch tracks to avert fatal collision. Monorail velocity critical. Activate brakes to slow down.